This is the stately starter machine. The initial state is where the machine starts. Each state is a rectangle and describes the machine's status or mode. A machine can only be in one state at a time. States are connected by transitions. Those are the arrows, and are triggered when an event happens. Events are those pill shapes. Sometimes your transitions will only happen depending on a condition. These conditions are called guards and are represented by the numbered if and else pill shapes. A machine also has a parent state with child states. Child states can only be active when their parent state is active. When you're ready to create your own machine, you probably want to delete all the states and events in the starter machine. You can do this by dragging to select and use the backspace key to delete everything selected. We're going to make a video player. Double-click the state to rename it. Add a state using the plus icon menu. All states are child states of the machine, also known as the root state. The first state in our video player is playing. Use any of the handles around a state to create a connecting event and target state. When our machine receives the pause event, it will transition to the paused state. We don't want our machine to autoplay, so our initial state should be playing. Change the initial state by selecting the desired state, using the triple dot menu and choosing mark as initial state. Now our pause event goes to playing, so we can fix that by selecting the pause event and using the triple dot menu to switch the source and target states. You can add markdown descriptions to any state or event. Use the plus icon menu to add a description and use the edit icon to add your description text. I'll add a link to a Figma document. That link is now a clickable link in our video player machine. Another way to create new states is double-click anywhere on the canvas. Our video player is going to start in a mini closed mode and open to full screen. So this new state will be closed and will create a new open state too. The closed state will now be our initial state. Drag from the handle on one state to connect it to a target state and create a new event. The video player will go from closed to opened on play. Next, we want the playing and paused functionality to only happen when the video player is opened. We can quickly make these into child states by dragging to select them, using the Command and C keyboard shortcut to copy them, delete them with backspace, then select the open state and paste the child states inside. Hold down the space key while dragging to pan across the canvas. We get warnings because these states are unreachable. There's no initial state, so we'll make playing the initial state. Now our video player is transitioning to playing on pause. Another way to switch the source and target states is to drag the ends of the transition to swap them to different states. Next, I'll create a stopped state and a stop event connected from the parent opened state. Now our video player could be stopped at any time when it is in the open state. You can drag your states and events to any position you like to make your machine easier to read. Drag to select multiple states and events and move them together. A state machine can fire off effects called actions. On our playing state, I'll use the plus icon menu to add an entry action for play video that fires when the playing state is entered. I'll also add a pause video exit action when the playing state is exited. We can add the implementation details for these actions in our code later. A running state machine can also be described as an actor. An actor is a running process that can receive and send events and change its behavior based on the events it receives and cause effects outside of the actor. Here, we'll use the plus icon menu to invoke a video player actor that will be started when the open state is entered and stopped when the opened state is exited. We'll use the edit icon button to open the actor details panel and give our actor an ID. This will make it easier for the code implementation later. Finally, we want to ensure our video player closes when the video is stopped or ended. Make a state into the final state using the triple dot menu and selecting state type final. The final state represents the successful completion of our open state. Then I'll use a state done event to transition back to the closed state when the opened state is complete. You can simulate your state machine by switching to simulate mode at the top of the editor. In simulate mode, you can walk through your machine as if it were live. To start, your machine will be in the initial state, and you can click any of the highlighted possible events to take them to the next state. The video player starts in closed, and I can only take the play event. From the open state and its initial playing state, I can pause, which takes me to the paused state. But there's no play event to take me back to playing if we wanted to resume the video player. I'll jump back into design mode, select the pause state, and drag a new transition to playing with a play event. Now I can return to simulate mode, take the play event, pause event, and now I can take the new play event back to playing again. Taking the stop event will transition through the undone, taking me back to the closed state again. You can review the steps taken by opening the log panel. Now we have a working machine, we can export the code to our XState project. Select the code panel to get the code for the machine. We're using JavaScript and get the code using the copy code button. Here's a project I made earlier. I'll paste my machine into the code and save. The current state is displayed in text so you can see how my video player goes through the state machine states. Closed, press play for opened and playing, pause for opened and paused, play again, then when the video is ended or stopped, the video player has transitioned back to closed. Finally, I want to show you some of the features available to our pro users, starting with color. Select the color swatch to choose from the color palette. I'll choose green for playing, red for stopped, and yellow for paused. Now I've made those changes, I want to save a new version of my machine to the version history. To do this, open the versions panel, save a new version, and if you want, you can give your version a custom name. As a pro user, I can also choose to make my project unlisted or private, and move the project to a team to share it with my stately teammates.